Alright, hello everybody and welcome to what should be episode 10, I think, of Let's Play Wuthering Waves. And I'm going to try and manage one more episode. I am actually quite tired, so I should probably get some sleep soon, but I'd like to get an extra 5 episodes so that I can put something out for this. So we're going to kind of screw around with some stuff. I'm probably not going to continue the story just yet. We're going to take a small break from that. Let's get some of these other things out of the way. So we have a new trophy. Journey. Complete Echoing March. Okay. And then we also have tutorials. Gravitation Vortex. I guess that was something that we had gotten previously when we were doing that one racing challenge. And how about mail? Let's see. Okay. There's 2 surveys. Social media website out now. Oh no, that's not a survey. This is just a social media website. Follow our official social media account via the link below to get updates and astrate times 60. Each player can only obtain the rewards once. Oh fuck, hold on. Okay. Well, I've done that. Claim. Now the question is, where the fuck is my mail? It said you'll get your mail. I've been lied to. Alright, fine. I guess they get a free subscription on YouTube. Oh, that's not what I want. Okay, well, let's do the survey then. Proceed to fill out questionnaire. Hopefully it lets me do it here. Now let's see how similar this is to stuff we've done. Yeah, I agree. It's fine. Just do whatever you want with my shit. I'm a nobody anyways. 25 years old of age. Isn't that amazing? Aren't I old as shit? I am currently playing on a laptop PC. I'm playing on a PC, a desktop. Wait. Oh no, this just is what you play 6. Okay, I should read these. Which devices have I been using to play games? Okay, it's both of these. Please note, for clarity, we consider cross-platform games that are available on mobiles, PCs, and consoles as mobile games. Please make sure your answers are in line with classification. What? We consider cross-platform games that are available on mobile, PC, and console as mobile game. Then it's not a mobile game, right? I'm sorry, if you're playing it on PC or on a console, it's not a mobile game just because it has cross-platform capability. That defeats the purpose of why it's called mobile. You know why it's called mobile, right? Because it's on a mobile device. It is mobile. This is, whatever. Which of the following genres best describes the games you play on PC or console most often? Oh, crap. It's one of these surveys, so we're going to be here for about half an hour. Let's see. I can choose up to 7 choices. So what do I like to play the most of these options? Well, action RPGs. Let's see, other roguelikes. Okay, I love those. Tactical shooters. Yes, Call of Duty, the number one tactical shooter game. Sandbox survival games, absolutely. Level-based puzzle solving, I do, but I need to see if I can pick any others in here. Casual puzzle fighting games, 4X. Open world games, yes. Non-action RPGs. Dating simulators. Sorry. music games. Oh, like rhythm games. That's 4 that we've picked up. This one, action RPGs and interactive movie games. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. I mean, a lot of these other ones apply too. Like, I like MMORPGs, for example. I like puzzle games and stuff, so. But I was just picking the ones that probably most apply to me right now. Which of the following PC and console games have you thoroughly experienced? I.e. completed the game or played more than 20 hours. Not Elden Ring, Monster Hunter. One of the games, but Ninja Gaiden. That's Grand Blue Fantasy, never played. Rise of the Ronin, not played. Sekiro, not played. Star Ocean, not played. The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, played a shitload of that. I haven't beaten Final Fantasy 16, but I did play it for quite a while there at the beginning of the year. Not played God of War, not played Dynasty Warriors. Ghost of Tsushima, which is a very recent game. That's another active LP I'm working on right now. Assassin's Creed, I haven't beaten, if you want to count the series, but I've played more than the 20 hours. Dark Souls, no. Fallen Dynasty, no. Bayonetta series, no. Lies of P. Devil May Cry series, no. Demon Souls, no. No. I have played Nier Automata for a little while, but I didn't play very much of it, so I'm not going to count that. Next. Which of the following PC console games have you thoroughly experienced? Oh, it's just a bunch more. Far Cry, I please play the shit out of that. I've got hundreds of hours in like each of the Far Cry games. Super Mario Odyssey. No. Kirby series, no. Uncharted series, yes. Played that one as a kid lots. I've definitely put more than 20 hours into Breath of the Wild, I'm pretty sure. But I haven't beaten it. Captain Toad. No. Death Stranding, no. Tomb Raider series, yes. Xenoblade Chronicles, I've not played before. Portal series, yes. Hogwarts Legacy, not played. Marvel Spider-Man series, haven't played, but I'm very interested in Watch Dogs. I own them, I've never played them. Grand Theft Auto V, I've unfortunately put a lot of time into. Elder Scrolls series, I've put more than 20 hours into it, but I have like very little experience, so I'm not going to count it. Cyberpunk 2077, looking forward to playing it, but haven't played it yet. Red Dead Redemption series, would love to play it, but the first game's not on PC. Next. With a new game, what elements in it would inspire you to try it out? Okay, so this is what gets me to do the playing. Gameplay designs with random elements to keep the experience fresh and replayable. It's... I can only choose up to 7. I mean, it really varies. You know, like, all of these could be... Like, graphics, for example, aren't super important to me, but they are still important. Like, they're not super important, but graphics do still matter. The style of a game does matter to me a lot. Now, you know, if you're... When I say graphics, like, you know, you have outdated graphics from 20, 30 years ago, you know, it's less the graphics that will be an issue for me and more the outdated game mechanics that are an issue for me. But a style means a lot. And if a style of a game just looks like shit to me, I don't want to play it probably because my eyeballs will burn. But compared to everything else, I don't know if that's as important. Freedom, leveling, and development. Okay. Gameplays that encourage leveling, equipment, upgrading, character development. That is something that I'm very interested in. I like progression. I see storyline. Of course, it's a collection. Collectible elements in the game. Yes. That is something I love. Hate competition. Casual character design. Characters whose personality, backstory, and other designs interest you. That is also something I'm interested in. But then again, there's all these other ones. Immersiveness, full immersion experience while playing the game. Freedom, high degrees of freedom, and how player can interact with the in-game world. Combat and interactive. Yes, that's also quite important, assuming the game even has that. Exploration, that's important. Variety of gameplay, that's important. It says spin-off mini-games in addition to core combat gameplay. It's a little bit vague, but... World design and theme, that's important. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6... challenges, graphics. I can only pick one more. I'll go with the random elements. Like, but strategy and all this other stuff. Oh man, there's so many in here that I actually would really like to choose too, but I'll roll with that for right now. I think that's still accurate. Among the aforementioned elements, which one makes up the highlight of your experience with Wuthering Waves? I go with combat for right now. I haven't played very much of the game yet, guys, but I mean, that's not your fault. I'm doing the survey early, I guess. But so far of what I've played, I mean, the exploration is fun too, but I haven't played enough to really say. So right now I'd say the highlight is probably just the way that the combat feels. What are your main reasons that bring you to try? Okay, so this is why did I want to try it? Well, to be fair, I didn't really know anything about it until, like, the day of its release. I'm eager to experience cultivation... I don't know what the hell cultivation means. Well, I know what it means, but I don't know in context of the game. I'm interested in the ecosystem. I'm keen on exploring... Okay, that's one thing. Definitely. I'm interested in co-op. My friends recommended it. Enjoyed punishing... I guess technically that applies. I enjoyed punishing Grey Raven. I've never played that. Wuthering Waves has received positive feedback. I am fascinated by... You cannot tell me that I've got another fucking mark on my lenses. Are you serious? Alright, give me a moment. Oh, jeez, man. Okay, let's see. Wuthering Waves has positive feedback. I'm fascinated by Wuthering Waves' world-setting storyline. I'm fond of the music and voice acting. I'm impressed by the scene art. I simply enjoy trying new games. Wuthering Waves has been widely discussed. I enjoy puzzle mechanics. I'm attracted to the character art. I guess I'll say the character art, too. There's not much I can really pick here because, like I said, I didn't know anything about the game until just a day ago. 2 days ago. How much do you like ACG-influenced content? What the fuck does ACG mean? I don't even know what that means. ACG. Okay. I guess it's a niche thing. It's apparently a Far East Asian culture, I guess. But it means anime, comics, and games, supposedly, according to Google. And I had to double search that. I did not know this was a thing, but if we want to talk about anime, comics, and gaming-influenced content, I guess I would say that I like it very much, though I was not aware of this prior. What does ACG-influenced content mean to you? They provide me with topics and conversations. I enjoy the plot, art, style, voice actors. I only get to pick one. I have genuine affection. Oh, great. Do I need to, like, get all philosophical here? They're just another leisure time activity. No, games are important to me. ACG content provide me with a sense of belonging, emotional support. If we consider Genshin Impact in ACG content, I've literally gone to that in moments of an emotional breakdown more than once, specifically to help make me feel better. So I'd say that that's an applicable option. They earn me recognition and attention. I don't give a shit. They just follow casually. Don't care. I mean, okay. The two I would... I mean, I enjoy the art style especially is really appealing to me in anime games. The music as well. But I think I'd probably have to go with this because as depressing as you might say, it is nice to, you know, feel like I belong when I can sit and play and explore in a world like this and just forget about the real world for a little while, if possible. But I was going to say this whole genuine affection thing, you know, this is an old school thing about falling in love with people that aren't real. I've dealt with that, you've dealt with that, we've all gone through that shit in our favorite cartoons, our favorite anime, our favorite video games, whatever it is. For who knows how many years. And yes, I still do hold actual genuine affection. Now, affection doesn't mean love. It doesn't have to mean you fall in love with a character. Maybe you genuinely care for these characters and you just don't want them to get their asses killed. But I'm referring to it by the affection of wanting to bone. Okay, no, don't go that far. The affection of actually loving a character that doesn't exist. Which for me, yes, in games like this, I certainly feel that way for lots of them. Nothing I can do about that, but I think this one here... The belonging and emotional support is probably more important and more relevant. Which of the following have you tried? Create ACG-related contents, fan arts. I mean, I've drawn anime characters. Does that count? I've listened to radio dramas. I've read fan fiction. I've listened to fan-made music. I collect and arrange and exhibit merches of your favorite characters. Yes, I do have anime figures and a pretty sizable collection of manga. I do read original web novels occasionally, not very often. Visit or follow ACG-related communities or creators. I do watch animations like Free Run Beyond Journey's End. Yes, I do, absolutely. Watch anime all the time. I watch anime-related video mixes, MMDs, hand-drawn MVs, dances. I do, especially dances, because they make me horny. Read cosplay content or be a cosplayer. I wish I could be a cosplayer, but I love following cosplay content. I'm not good enough for the actual cosplay. Play ACG-influenced games. Yes. Purchase ACG-related products, like merchandise, figures, comic books. Yeah, wait, then what is this? What is the difference between collect, arrange, and exhibit merches of your favorite characters versus purchase related products like merchandise, figures, and comic books? That seems redundant. Join ACG related clubs. I do not have a club. Attend ACG related activities in person. I wish I could, but I don't have the balls for that kind of thing. Read light novels. I do read light novels. I like how it goes from, the examples go from Bakemonogatari straight to My Little Sister Can't Be This Cute. what great examples. Read fan art or webtoon, of course. I don't know how you read fan art, but it's a thing. Listen to ACG-influenced music. Vocalize anime OSTs. I'm always listening to anime OST. It's just one of the things that I'm always doing. And then I also like none of the above for the... Oh, shit. Fuck. Okay. Which of the following fan content do you like to see in your favorite... to see for your favorite game? Okay. Favorite fan content. I like to see... I'm not... memes are funny, but I am not a meme culture person. So that's not the my favorite thing to see. I like seeing... I mean, I do use character development guides, but that's not my favorite. MMD is not my favorite. I hate YouTube poop, so that is not something that's up my alley. Assuming that's what YTP means. Exploration guides, no. Story walkthroughs, no. Webtoons and memes. I don't, again, memes and fun memes. MAD, game content remix, game music videos. Fan fiction is something I'm always interested in, though I don't dabble in it, like, a lot. But I am interested in it. Lore world setting research. That is something I can spend hours doing if I get interested enough in it. Hand-drawn animation. I love that kind of stuff. Cosplay content. I adore cosplay content of, like, Genshin characters. Holy crap, there are some amazing cosplayers out there. Scene art illustrations. Quest guides. No. Boss, other enemy challenge, no. Character illustrations, absolutely. Illustrated internet stickers. I don't know what that's supposed to be. But song covers and instrumental covers. I love listening to fan makes of those. Story-related illustrations. I guess I'll... I don't know. Fan music, character theme songs. Limited time event guides. Player highlights. Now, of course, if we're being honest here, there's a type of fan art of anything that exists. It rules the internet. It always has. And if it exists, well, there's porn of it. But... Alright, next page. Let's see. Through which channels do you primarily obtain information about your favorite games? Okay, so this is explicitly, including but not limited to obtaining official news, watching fan-created content. Okay, so where do I engage in activities of my games? Not Facebook anymore. Not really Twitter. Not PC Gamer. Not Instagram. From friends. From, I don't know, I use fandom, but I don't, I'm not active there. Discord, IGN, no. TikTok, no. Games Radar, I don't even know if I know what that is. Twitch, no. Influencers, I don't watch many big influencers that also cover stuff that I'm interested in, like Genshin and stuff, so I'm not going to count that. YouTube, yes. Pocket Gamer, I don't know what that is. Reddit, I've used it, but it's not something I'm active on. Eurogamer, no. GameSpot, no. Okay. That's good enough. Among them, which channel do you use the most? Discord. Actually, YouTube. YouTube and Discord. The place I get most of my information from would be YouTube. That's where most of the fan content is, not counting fan illustrations. Through what channel did you first learn about Wuthering Waves? That would be Discord. Where's that? Right here. How did you engage with the player community on social media? I neither make posts nor follow others' opinions. Wait. Oh. I think there was something that said I create YouTube content. But it doesn't look like I can go back. But that isn't how I was meant to engage. What industry do you work in? Oh my god. Dude. Mining? What do you mean mining? Do you mean like Bitcoin mining? Like cryptocurrency here, like, or grab your pickaxe and go out and start chopping away at the stone. Professional services. No, man, you expect me to be able to answer this? Real estate, logistics, international, internet, gaming. I work in the internet industry, I guess. Electricity and gas. That's where I get my funds. That's where I get my payments, is from internet. From YouTube, from Patreon, education, training, yeah. I'm not into any of the... I don't have an actual, you know, life, as they say. Please tell us your gender? ? I am a male. Oh my god, that took an hour to do. It took almost 20 minutes. You've completed the survey. Well, thank you. Claim. And look at that. There's my 60 things. Oh, no, that's for following the social media. Oh, maybe it just takes a while then. Oh, shit. And here's the survey. Okay. Awesome. The big awesome. All right, so do we want to look at this guidebook then? Because we've got basic training. Let's see. Dodge. Proceed to the dodge tutorial. This is going to be really important stuff for me. All right, they want me to use Young Young for this. Dodge. Perform dodge at the right moment to avoid enemy attacks. Successful dodge grants damage immunity for a limited time, letting you perform additional attacks or whatever. All right, dodge. Wait, how do you dodge? Okay. For some reason, I forgot how to dodge. All right, complete two dodge counters. So that's where I dodge and then attack, maybe? Press left shift now. Yeah, but how do you do dodge counter, though? Okay, there I... After six... Oh, yeah. Well, I did that earlier. I literally did that. Strange. Practice more and defeat the enemies. After successful dodge counters, press to trigger the special derivative attacks. What? I don't know what a derivative attack is, but special enhanced attack is heavy attack monsoon. Right, you're a healer. You're just here to keep me alive. And then we're gonna give him a chance to stand up. Okay, well, I'll definitely take the rewards for this. So that was dodging. That's like one of the few things I actually... I'm not confused about in combat, so... Yeah, other than the timing, I just need to figure out when the hell I am supposed to dodge certain enemies. Like during that boss fight, man, holy crap, his attacks were so fast. Okay, let's see. The next one. Okay, so now outro skill. Here's something I kind of understand. But then I don't understand the intro and outro skill. That's what I'm confused about. Resonators gain energy when dealing damage or performing dodges in combat. When it gets full, the other resonator will icons will glow up. Switch your resonator when the energy is full to trigger the exiting outro skill and consume all the energy to trigger the incoming intro skill. So I guess I never realized that when you switch out, they do something. I always thought it was just whoever you're switching into does something. Switch to a character. Yes. Okay, I can do that. Oh, maybe it was that big fire thing that was on the ground there. That was her outro skill. What the fuck is this? Holy shit, big monkey. Is that something that her... did that say Yang Yang's outro skill? Oh, okay. Right. So that's what the outro skill means. It's just, I guess each character does something additional. But it's hard to miss because you see the intro skill actively played out, but the outro skill is like just some leftover thing. You can view outro skill in Resonator's menu. Resonator skill, Oh, here's the outro. It's this symbol down here. The fuck? I didn't even know that was a thing. Encore generates a thermal field centered around skill target with a radius of 3 meters. Targets inside thermal field are continuously burned, suffering fusion damage equal to 176.76% of Encore's attack every 1.5 seconds for 6 seconds. Hmm. Okay, well still, that's useful. But learning about how the characters play is especially useful. So like if I click on Encore, I'm assuming this is just going to teach me each of how she works. Now, I think I know how Encore works at this point, but of course I don't really know, you know, is there a certain order of attacks and stuff that I should be doing? I'm not really sure about that. Let's see. Interact with the Remnant key. When attacks hit, okay, so restore mayhem. Sorry, that's a full set of attacks. Hold for a heavy. There we go. This is really cool, actually. Having just a full an air attack. There we go. Having like a full tutorial about all of the skills and everything, and it even tells me. So, skill. And skill extra. I didn't realize that you had a skill extra. Oh, okay, I did not know that. Hold while mayhem is full. Right, when it is full, use heavy attack to enter mayhem state and take okay, I guess she takes reduced damage, so even though I can still take hits, it's reduced. But a big attack is performed. Okay, and now alt. And then just use attacks, go ham. And then heavy attack. Okay, that was... See, I didn't know there was actually two things you can do there for the skill. So I actually learned something here. But how do I know when to cast it again? I guess just before the animation fully plays out. Okay, noted. This is a great feature. The feature to teach you about how to play your characters, each of the characters. The closest thing to that that you get in Genshin Impact is probably the play tests, and that's only for when the characters are available on the banners. And you have to read the text to tell you how things work. It doesn't, you know, actively have you play with each of the things and say, here, do this in this order. So that's actually a pleasant surprise here. And that's very helpful for me when that's something I've been mostly confused about so far is the character stuff. So I will probably continue to do those, and it'll probably be more pertinent to do them whenever I decide to play with a specific character. But I will do all of them because they give you rewards at some point. But I'm trying to see, we're up to 28 minutes flumping around. I'm very tired right now, so it's definitely a good time to probably stop. But I don't want this to be just a half hour video, so I'm going to, let's see. Maybe if I do... Oh, that's not it. That's not what I'm trying to pick. Events. Yeah, here. If we proceed through these, maybe we can do some play tests and get these out of the way. So, like, let's see. How about you, whatever. Yeah, this is more what I'm used to. Cover Forte gauge on hit. Cast enhanced resonance skill when Forte gauge is full. Alright, here we go. We got Mr. Science Man. He's guns, of course. Alright, who are you? Hello. Oh, boobs. That's who you are. You're the boob girl. Okay. Anyways. I'm just gonna do what I do in Genshin and smack a bunch of buttons and see what happens. Don't you? Who are you and what does this do? I don't know, but you're pink. Pink is a cute color. Oh, you are a bitch, aren't you? Oh, there's his burst. What does that do? It looks like it adds extra attacks. Oh, you bring out the big chungus now, huh? Alright. So I'm just smacking the buttons so I can get my extra reward here. Holy shit. Does that actually carry over on other characters? It looks like it does. What is her holding button? When I hold her attack, she like kneels down. What? Is that a shield? Great. And now I have even more reason to not really care too much about the playtests because there's a tutorial for each of the playable characters. The playtest is less important to learn how they play. Unless, of course, I want to pull for that character, and that's my opportunity to play with them to see what they're like. That's the exception, I guess. So I don't really have to worry about trying to learn in the playtest. I can just willy-nilly it like I always do, and then do their actual tutorial when I want to learn how to properly play them. Alright, and this character I have a little bit of experience with, so I don't think that'll be too bad. Okay, yeah, hold the E. Can I not do that without the forte stuff? No, okay, that specifically needs the forte. And they gave us that pink-haired girl again. Shit. Perfect. Flipping perfect. Ow, my thumb. Oh, God. What a waste, man. Okay, now this is another new character that I've not seen, so I'm trying to tell. Right. Danjin, I guess? Not sure what that symbol is. There's fire, and then whatever that is. Is that, like, chaos or some shit? Uh-oh. She's adorable. And that's a problem. Because that means I'm gonna want her. Havoc. Okay, basically chaos, I guess. Ventral Blades, Condensed Blood in Hand, Ranger Dungeon. Dungeon, whatever, hunts down thieves and bandits for retribution. She journeys to distant lands in pursuit of justice. Okay. She's a sword user. What kind of sword user? DPS, sub-DPS, support? I don't know. Okay. Recover Forte for resident skill on hit. Hold basic attack to cast enhanced heavy attack and recover HP. Forte gauge is no less than half. Confusion. When Forte gauge is above 50%, hold left mouse and left mouse. What the fuck? Kind of what? Kind of tutorial is that? Hold the same button twice. Ruby Shades, dodge counter, plus E, plus E? Oh god, Jesus, man. I'm too tired for this shit. Just roll with it right now. But she's got, like, these cute little twirly things on her hair. Oh, I like what they did with the character eyes, too. They've got that anime thing going on where you can, like, see the eye outlines between the hair, or through the hair. I kind of like that. Alright, alright. Hey guys. Okay. They said dodge counter is... And then press E twice. Well... Oh no, I have to dodge counter. So I do that, then that, then E, then E. Okay, so that's actually one of her specific things. What does this do? Oh my god, why does she look like a yandere? Oh man. Hey guys. What the fuck was that? Holy shit. It just whacks a whole bunch. Oh my god, I think I found another character I want to play with. I didn't do it fast enough there. Huh. I don't know. She was fun to play with. She's got the thing going on where I said, like, aesthetically, she makes me feel things. She's cute. I like what she's wearing. I like these floaty things on her butt. Not her butt, I guess, but her back. Whatever these weird, like, tassel things are. I like her burst animation. It's all aesthetically very appealing to me. Though I couldn't tell you... I mean, she felt fine to play, but... Hell if I know how to actually do her accurately. And that leaves just the 5-star, who we got to play with a little bit there during the story. Very convenient that he's the first event banner, and you get to play with him after a cool cutscene. Okay, Emerald Storm, finale. Yeah. Just a bunch of smacky things. Hey guys, how's it going? He is fun to play, though. There's that. I would expect that from 5-star. He's just install like crazy game. Holy fuck, dude. What the hell? Okay. Jeez. Well, that's that out of the way. Got a drink too. I'm gonna pop the air on here because I think I'll be stopping this video soon anyways. Alright, claim. Thank you, claim. Thank you. Claim. Thank you, and claim. Thank you. So I've noticed that the characters don't seem to have their own specific level up and ascension materials. It looks like it's just universal. Which, might streamline the leveling process a little bit. Okie dokes. So this video is only about 40 minutes. I know it's a bit on the shorter end, but I am getting genuinely a bit too tired to keep playing. So I'll have to come back and continue this at a later date, which might be later today, might be tomorrow. Who knows? Anyways, but I'll try to get these 5 episodes out some point soon here. And hold on, let me see. Was that character that we were playing with? I'll recognize her name. It's this person here. They don't let me look at her, damn it. If I go to the standard banner and look, is she in the banner? Whoops, that's not what I want. Information. For, yeah, Dungeon. She's one of the in the standard banner characters. Okay, so possibilities of getting her down the road. And then, of course, if I pulled on this, I'm not sure yet what I'm going to be doing with the event banner, because I probably want to... I'm going to try to keep playing for a little while. Not right now, I mean, but before I decide to do any event banner stuff. And I'm going to see, like, if there's any news about upcoming characters. Because I might want to start from the very beginning, being very careful with what I spend. Because back when we started Genshin, you know, I started working at... working retail, yay. But I started having an actual proper income. And I was able to throw some cash at that game every once in a while. When event banner... polls were a thing for me back then, but nowadays I can't do that. I have to be very careful with what I pull for, and so I often have to skip characters and wait and save up for the characters that I'm looking forward to. And right now, as a free-to-play player, that's what I have to do in this game until I have, you know, a proper income to facilitate throwing money at gacha games. But that remains to be seen. So until I learn more about that, I won't have an answer. Just yeet. Anywho, that's going to bring this to an end. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next episode, where hopefully I have a nice big old pot of energy to suck from.